thing that I noticed is the KG class is all ready to go. And if you notice their hands coming up like this, can you show us? That means that they're asking you if you can be quiet so we can get ready for the next presentation. We are so fortunate today to have the fabulous kindergarten class who practiced a lot for this. So let's show them how we are the best audience at ASIJ by doing two things. One, sitting on our bottom so everybody can see. And two, staying quiet. Even though we get excited about something and we want to share it with our neighbor, we can share it when we leave. Okay? So staying quiet in between presentations. So let's be an excellent audience. And here we go, KG.
Hello, my name is Emma. Welcome to our gathering. We are from kindergarten and we are excited to be your leaders. Jason, let's remember ASIJ core values, character, courage, and compassion.
Hi, my name is Ari. So far this year, we have talked about character and courage in our gatherings. We are excited to be the first class to share the core value compassion.
We've been working on it for the past several days. Let's sing it with our heartfelt compassion and grow in compassion every day. Here we go. I won't let go. Let's hear your best job.
is like a star that carves a path. It breaks your will. It feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost on your own. You're not alone.
Okay, let's hear it.
I will stand by you. I will help you through. But you've done all you can do, and you can't go. I will dry your eyes. I will fight your fight. I will hold you tight, and I will.
One more time, here we go.
I will stand by you. I will help you through. But you've done all you can do, and you can't go. I will dry your eyes. I will fight your fight. I will hold you tight, and I will.
Well, I went to the nurse many times. I bring children to the nurse's office, and then I've gone to the nurse because I was sick one day, and the nurses took such good care of me. They looked after me, made sure I was okay. They brought me to the doctors, and they do that every day with all the children that go to the nurse, and they go to help them every single day.
So sometimes compassion is in a voice, and sometimes compassion is in a thing, because she gave him an ice pack to make him feel better.
The health center called and asked if they could bring, like, my bag. And so, like, my brother came in there and said, do you want me to walk you to the buses? And I said, yeah. So he did, but I was still waiting for my bag. And so, like, Sam came and brought my bag.
Like, I just saw yesterday, up in the fitness room, there was teachers that brought in students that were blind, that they couldn't see. And they matched them up with a high school student that could see, and they were touring the school and actually having them going through a fitness routine up in the fitness room, working out with the blind person or the blind student, with a sighted person, and they were working together to find out what it's like to have to work out on the machines and helping them.
In the recess time, when he helped me find the thing, so, and I thought it was not on the bus, but we looked at the bus list and found there wasn't.
I also find compassion in little things such as opening the door, not for the whole group, but only for the person that's behind you. Things that are little as that show compassion, and when you do it every day, every time, it really builds up.
Do you see compassion in SIJ?
Do I see compassion all the time? I think this is such a great place to be. So one story of compassion I want to share is one about Mr. Faulkner, actually. It's not only about students, but teachers are showing compassion too. So every day in the morning, you guys know I have two kids at home, Kieran and Carter, those little guys. And I'm very, very busy and I'm always rushing to get to work. And when I get to school, I have to get our classes ready. And we have to get lots of equipment ready and things ready to go for class. So every morning when I come here, Mr. Faulkner knows Mr. Harrison is really busy. I'm going to help him. And he comes down here every morning before I get here and he gets all this stuff ready for me. Isn't that kind of him?
Yeah.
So, I go to this after school called Lego for Love, where we build Legos and then we put them in cans and then we send them to people who never seen Lego. And then they play with it.
Have you seen someone show compassion?
Yes. At our school, we have a wonderful group called the Student Council. And what they're doing right now is showing compassion. What they do is they collect socks to help the homeless people in Tokyo. So they collect all these socks, and then once they get all of them, they're going to deliver it to them so that their feet can stay warm
during the winter.
It was cold right now, right?
Okay, sometimes when I might look sad, my friends or my teacher might ask me, are you okay or how are you doing? Something like that.
The kindergarten class
wants to thank everyone
who shares stories
about compassion.
Hi, boys and girls. As Kaylee just said, we're going to sing this song that so many of you know, this Light of Mine, but we're going to have the kindergarten sing it first, and then I'll turn around and I'll bring you in. So when you'll get to join us on verse 3. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ken. Thank you for being a good audience. Please always show compassion to others.
Can we get one more big round of applause for our kindergarten? They were pretty amazing. They had to sit here for about an hour. They've been here no more than that. They came here at 8 o'clock. So for kindergartners to do this for an hour, to stay focused and present for all of you, I think we need to do one more big applause. Nice job, KG. We're very, very proud of you. Fourth graders, you can start heading out the back.